This is TWiT.
I think themes are something you notice depending on your coverage, right? So I focused a lot on laptops this CES, and there was just a lot of exciting change happening in laptops that I wasn't expecting. NVIDIA announced a new ray tracing chip for laptops. So that's going to bring really powerful gaming performance to gaming laptops. And sure enough, a whole bunch of gaming laptop makers announced that they would have laptops with that specific NVIDIA RTX 2060 chip inside. And then Intel also had some news about it launched a new set of desktop class chipsets that's not necessarily for laptops, but more about the PC space. But it also showed off new architecture for its next generation of chips that would be really cool. So basically, they have this hybrid architecture that will let you stack things like RAM or memory on top of the CPU footprint. And so conserve a lot of space, but still bring performing power that you would want out of a laptop. So it's setting the stage for a very exciting year ahead for PCs. And AI also comes into this, to Stacey's point, where they're trying to look into how to use AI to better manage performance, how to use AI to better manage battery power. So personally, because I'm a PC nerd, I think there's a lot of PC news out of CES that I wasn't expecting that excited me.
Yeah, I mean, you know, CES is... I guess to some degree always had a lot of PCs, but you don't expect to see big announcements at CES because there's so many other things going on there. Usually people defer to Computex or other events. Mm-hmm. But it's interesting. Is it mostly design? I mean, I feel like to some degree PCs are at a plateau. There's not a lot more you can do with a PC, but it sounds like there's maybe some innovation too, not just design.
Yeah, I'm with you. I mean, I thought that they were stagnating too, but last year we had a resurgence of PC tech, and this year it seems like there's even more to expect. Design, performance, we're looking at every year, but this year we're also looking at more and more connected laptops. So laptops that will be always online, always connected to say, at least LTE. We're also expecting the first 5G laptops to be available in 2019. Yes. That's another buzzword, right? 5G all over CES, even though not a lot of people had product to show for it, but everyone was like, we're going to make a 5G version of this at some point this year. And that's a lot of hype. We are expecting to see the first 5G networks and products roll out this year. But just because they were talked about at CES doesn't mean there was anything to show. Netgear had, I think, a 5G hotspot to launch, and then there was also 5G chipsets that Intel showed off that they meant to apply in things like base stations. So there was some news, but it wasn't the big splash about 5G that I was expecting coming into the show.
It does. Well, first of all, I guess I would ask, maybe Stacey, I know you've been following this. How far out is widespread 5G availability in the U.S.? Is it a year out, 2 years out, 5 years out?
If we're talking about like the 3GPP standard, because that's the other thing, everyone calls everything 5G.
Well, AT&T's getting heat because of 5GE, which is really LTE.
So if
Verizon's
we're talking about
doing
true
something
5G,
different, 5G,
which is
in
why
their home.
Qualcomm changed that one thing in their booth. They had their pre-CES PR blast that showed Qualcomm 5G.
Yeah,
they changed it. Their signage changed in their booth to Qualcomm. Real 5G. I'm like, oh, okay.
So when is real 5G going to be available, Stacey?
Widespread and in use?
Yeah.
End of 2019, I would say. I mean, you are going to see networks that are using it. You're not going to see it on phones for a while.
But it would be reasonable, since you're going to own that laptop for a few years, or a phone even for a couple of 3 years.
Well, so wait.
At this
so
point, to think about something that might have 5G capability if it's going to be available in a year.
It's more of a
premise. We have to look at the spectrum too. Yeah. So there's two things. There's the 5G radio spec that is done by the 3GPP, which does all the cellular standards. And then there's what some people call 5G, like when AT&T. When Verizon's talking about 5G, they're talking about like, and they're doing it like for fixed broadband. Yeah. They're talking about using millimeter wave spectrum to like offer coverage in the home.
But that's not the standard that everybody's going to use when 5G really comes, right?
Well, it's unclear what's... So AT&T's using some of its millimeter wave spectrum. I think I can't remember which, if it's 28 or 34 or what. But they're also... They're going to have to use the same 5G standard over their 3G and maybe some of their 4G.
You get
spectrum.
What I'm asking, which is if you're going to buy a laptop, and nowadays I think you want
it depends a couple on of what things with a laptop.
You want a lot of battery, right? And I think that's one thing we're seeing. And you want, I think you would, if you want an LTE-enabled laptop, why not get one that's 5G capable? You're saying the standard isn't settled enough to choose.
Well,
one.
I'm saying we don't know what spectrum it's going to run over. So, if you're going to put a radio in, it has to cover.
Right.
So here's the thing. Okay, I spoke to Samsung and Qualcomm about 5G and the 5G rollout in 2019 as well. And, you know, the first 5G phones are coming in 2019. We are expecting Galaxy's,
Galaxy S10 will have it. Yeah.
Yeah. Here's the thing. To Stacey's point, I think what she's trying to get at is that like there are two parts to 5G NR, the new spectrum, the new specification that everyone's expecting to launch this year. There's the part that still feels a lot like LTE, and there's the part that's using millimeter waves. And to get that part working and what we think of as true 5G, a device has to have the radios, the antenna that do beamforming and beam tracing to pick up these very short frequency or short like distance waves. And that's what the industry, or at least I think of as true 5G. And so the phones that we're expecting to come out will have those. So the Snapdragon 855 was announced just last month, and that is compatible with 5G CPU, but without the radio that supports 5G, a phone announced with 855 might not support 5G.
You need the tunable antennas and the chip.
Well, and
exactly.
You also
listen to her.
The infrastructure.
She knows what she's talking about.
Yeah.
So actually, it sounds like, and are any of these 5G ready laptops, do any of them have those features?
We're not. We haven't seen any announced with them yet. Any. They're just saying that they're going to make them. So we need to see when the devices actually get announced, whether they have these antenna, these components that
That's
make them
to look for.
Millimeter wave. Yeah.
But you should see them. It's much easier to do like beamforming and cram more into a laptop than it is into a phone. So I would expect more capabilities from the laptop than just a plain phone.
Is it holding up manufacturers though that their standard is still in flux or?
The standard's not in flux. NR is specified and ready to go, but we are looking at the next stage, which is how to bring IoT into 5G. And that's what is more, looking forward. Right now, they have settled on NR, and
we have
NR
a spec. Is it up to implementation then? That's unknown.
Yeah. It's more or less ready to go. It's whether the carriers are going to deploy it widespread. Right. There's
how
a lot of infrastructure.
Yeah, exactly.
Because you have to remember, since you're using such a high frequency that does not penetrate nearly as well.
You need many more cell sites.
Far more. I mean, not just double or triple. It is an order of magnitude more.
Is it really that many more?
Yeah, it is. It's ridiculous.
But
I mean, it's fast, but you need
to be 5 feet away from a micro millimeter.
Well, so both Verizon and AT&T, though, when they actually do deployments, they're going to use both millimeter wave when they can, and then they're going to use other spectrum.
So
it's not all going to go. So, yes. You're gonna see them compatible.
So it would be fair to say it's even though the spec is defined, implementation is still in flux, and so buying 5G ready hardware today is difficult to do.